Well, this hand's good. This hand's much better than the other hand. It's got a Grim Lavamancer, a couple removal spells, and a Hordling Outburst. It sounds like a plan to me. All right. I even have the Fire Ice to cast off Steam Vents here, though. Still a slightly better chance that I just cast Fire. Let's see what my opponent is up to. Nada. Actually, I think I will cast. I've got a lot of burn spells, so I think I will cast Ice here. I'm going to Ice my opponent's, I think, Forest on their upkeep, so they can't cast something like Kitchen Finks. Seems like a pretty good deal. And I don't need another 2 damage burn spell. This cycles, so. I like it. If my opponent didn't do anything last turn, there's a good chance they didn't do anything this turn. I get to bash. Oh no, you have to play. Is it Abrupt Decay on my Grim Lavamancer? I would allow that. I'd rather have Abrupt Decay Grim Lavamancer than Hall of Triumph, because Hordling Outburst Hall of Triumph is a nice little combo. Smash. Hordling Outburst. And hope the opposition is not running some kind of board sweeper. There aren't that many in black-green, I gotta admit. There's a Damnation. I guess there's cards like Infest or Drown and Sorrow. I don't even know if they're in this cube. Next turn, I'm running out the Hall of Triumph and burning my opponent's blocker. Or something along those lines. Or potentially, if it's like a 4-4, running out Hall of Triumph, attacking with 3-2-2s, and having Grim Lavamancer up. Maelstrom Pulse. Alright, you got me. That's a good one. Alright. Play the Hall of Triumph. Get Grim Lavamancer in the hall. And attack. So I do have 11 points of burn in my hand. So I don't have that much more to go. I'm probably going to need another threat at some point. Skirmrender would verify that. Because now I have no threats. And I'm just going to pass. My opponent does just attack with Skin Render. I'm probably going to Searing Spirit, but I'm hoping they put an equipment on it. Though, I suppose I shouldn't hope they have Locks on Warhammer, because now I've got to win a long game against Locks on Warhammer, and I don't really have much expectation of killing my opponent anytime soon. I need to draw Imperial Recruiter or Siege Gang Commander. Elsewise, I could be in trouble. And it depends what my opponent's next creature is. If it's like a Troll Zedek, I'm just going to lose. A 4-5 Tarmogoyf? Tarmogoyf locks on Warhammer. I haven't seen that in a while. Alright. Well, I don't like that. Things are not looking good. Let's cast Burst Lightning with Kicker, followed by Firebolt. Now I think my chances of winning this game are very low. Because I have now nothing. And my opponent's got a Warhammer in play, and lots of life to play with. They have no creature here. I could just top deck a Siege Gang Commander, or I guess that's really it. All my other creatures are kind of small. But if they have a creature this turn, then I don't like where I'm at. Oh, that's the one. That is the one I fear most. Alright. Come on, Siege Gang. Are we equipping the Warhammer, or are we not equipping the Warhammer? No, we're playing something else. That cannot be good news for me. Spiteful Return. Well, that one's not so bad news, but I'm just going to concede anyway because I'm getting smashed for 7 by Kitchen Finks next turn. Alrighty. Still don't really think I want Ancient Grudge for one card, especially since I shouldn't be getting into that many super slow games anyway. Kind of makes me want Deep Analysis. I have now 2... blue sources for the Deep Analysis. I'm going to take out Winter Orb. My opponent's got too many creatures. You want to Winter Orb the control decks that have nothing on the board. You don't want to Winter Orb the creature decks. Alright. I like that.